Unhappy, he exclaimed. There is too much garbage to pick up. They want more workers. What will we do? Marcy realized that she wasn't nervous anymore. She thought for a moment and then snapped her fingers. We'll start a recycling program, she said. That will reduce garbage. They won't need more workers.
Great idea, said Mr. Clark.
In this part, Marcy faces a new problem, and as a mayor, she's supposed to find out a solution for it. Now, what was the problem? Pause the video, please, to answer. The problem was that there's too much garbage to pick up, and they want more workers, so they need more garbage collectors to collect the large amount of garbage found. Now, what was the thing that, or what was the solution that Marcy suggested? Marcy suggested starting a recycling program. Now, when we recycle garbage, it means that we take this garbage, we kind of like separate them. The glass alone, the plastic alone, paper alone, and we change them in special kind of processes in order to either make the same material again or to change it into something else. So I recently bought this bundle of papers, and if you see in this picture, they said 150 recycled rolled sheets. So see the sign of how the arrows turn in 360 degrees in order to form a circle? Now, whenever the sign is found on a certain product, it means that this product was recycled. And recycling is really beneficial or helpful for the environment. For example, the papers that you have here are made out of trees. So when I recycle the papers, it means that I no longer have to cut more trees to make more papers. I can use the papers I already made before and make them again as papers, as blank papers, and do whatever I want with them. Other materials can be recycled as well. For example, we have plastic. Plastic can be taken into special factories where special processes are made on the plastics. Or we can change, or we can use the plastic bottles that we have at home to make other things from them, like this adorable chair that was really made out of real plastic bottles, okay? So pieces of art can be even made from plastic bottles. So instead of throwing and burying the plastic containers, we can actually use them and save the environment from getting polluted.
After lunch, Mr. Clark ran into Marcy's office. You have a city council meeting in 5 minutes, he shouted. At the meeting, the head of the city council looked worried. The playground equipment at the city park needs fresh paint, she said. The park needs new flowers. But we have no money for extra workers.
In this part, Marcy meets with the city council. And as we know, the city council's job is to help the mayor find solution for the citizens' problems. Now, what was the problem that the citizens had? Pause the video to answer. According to the head of the city council, the playground equipment in the park need fresh paint. And the second problem is that the park needs new flowers. And these things cannot be done because they have no money for extra workers. So their real problem is that there is no money to get the job done. Let's continue reading to find out if Marcy was able to solve her problem.
Do we have money for ice cream? Marcy asked. The city council members looked confused. I will have a news conference today, Marcy explained.
Next Saturday will be our first Glenview Volunteer Day. People can volunteer at the park and enjoy free ice cream. The citizens of our city will paint and plant and get the job done. Wonderful idea, Mayor Marcy! The members cheered.
Let's give Marcy the applause she really deserves. So, eventually, she was also able to find out the solution for the city council's problem. Now, what was the solution? Can you tell me? Pause the video to answer. Marcy had the idea of offering free ice cream in exchange for people's help to rejuvenate or to renew the park again. How did I know that? It's from the text. She said that people can volunteer at the park and enjoy free ice cream.
At 5:30, Mr. Clark thanked Marcy for her hard work. They walked to the front of City Hall, where Marcy's mother was waiting. Marcy got in the car and stretched her legs. "Did you have fun, Marcy?" asked her mother. "I did," said Marcy. "Who knows?" said her mother. "Maybe you'll be a real mayor someday." Marcy smiled. "Maybe I will," she said.
After Marcy's busy day, she got inside her mother's car and stretched her legs. Does anyone know what does stretching the leg mean? This means that our poor Marcy had a long, tiring day, and she had to rest her legs by stretching them in the car. Marcy's mother asked, "Did you have fun, Marcy?" So, from this question, do you think Marcy's mother knew the amount of work that Marcy did during her day? I don't think so. What Marcy's mother said at the beginning of the story doesn't show that she knew or she even predicted that Marcy might be the actual mayor of the city. So all what she thought Marcy did was observe. So she told her, "Did you have fun?" After seeing how much time and effort Marcy had to exert or make during her day as a mayor, do you think the job of a mayor is a hard job or an easy job? Well, it is a hard job. And that's why the real mayor of Glenview was so eager and excited to give the responsibilities to Marcy and head to the beach with his beach ball. After we're done reading the whole lesson, let us kind of talk about the lesson in general. Now, do you think Marcy's personality changed from the beginning of the lesson till the very end? Did she grow as a person or she stayed the same? Pause the video to answer. The answer is yes. Since at the very beginning of the story, we said that she was nervous. Remember how the way she talked with the mayor and she said, "I'll do my best, sir," in a trembling voice. Now, while she was cutting the ribbon, she told them a speech and she was a bit confident of herself while doing that. Now, afterwards, when she was talking with the president of the toy company, she impressed the president and she talked in confidence and she guaranteed or promised the president that the people of Glenview will build interesting and creative toys. And later, she successfully solved the garbage collector's problems and the problem of the city council regarding the park. So as you can see, she's no longer nervous. She's no longer hesitant. She's now confident of herself, and she believes she's strong and she can solve problems, or she can solve any problem she faces. And at the very end, when her mom told her that maybe you'll be a mayor one day, She said, maybe I will. So this is a kind of a clue for us that shows that Marcy really liked the job of a mayor, and perhaps in the future she's gonna try to pursue her dream of becoming a mayor one day. Now, who is the main character of this story? I think the answer is pretty easy. The answer is Marcy, of course, because she's the person or the character that the story is mostly about. She's the one who does most of the talking in the story. She's the one that the story keeps talking about. Now, concerning the minor characters, minor is the opposite of main, okay? So the minor characters are the characters that do not talk a lot in the story, the characters that are only mentioned slightly in the story, okay? So they do not have a big effect on the story, okay? Now, who are the minor characters? They can be the mayor, the real mayor of Glenview. They can be Mr. Clark. They can be the mother, even the reporters, the president of the toy company. So all of these are considered as minor characters in the story of Mayor for a Day.